你好，我是 Leslie. You and I have watched the three clips of Mulan together. From these three clips, we have seen that Disney's creation has added a lot of light fun to the originally serious Chinese Mulan story. Whether it's the awkwardness of the first day in the army, the heartbreak after being discharged from the army, or the anxiety of preparing to join the army.Mulan and the Mushu's dialogues are positive and interesting. Comparing the English and the Chinese versions of Mulan, we found that there is almost no difference in the meaning of the dialogue between the two. But it is not a word-to-word correspondence, because authentic Chinese dialogue is not a simple text translation. It must be combined with the daily expression habits of Chinese people.I have already listed such words as 老天爷死路一条太阳晒屁股了 When hearing these words, the Chinese audience feel very familiar. There is no feeling that it is Disney's Mulan. Although these colloquialisms, slang, and idioms are just words or phrases, they best reflect the influence of Chinese culture, customs, and history on language.They convey the emotions, thoughts, social relationships, and values of the Chinese people. Because expression is simple and direct, with rich and vivid meanings, these authentic expressions are everywhere, whether in people's daily life or work communication, or official media and social networks. If I compare Chinese expression to a piece of clothing,Then, grammar is like the structure of the whole garment, which must be complete and clear. Words are like patterns on clothes. They can convey a lot of information. And colloquialism, slang, and idioms are like thoughtful little accessories that make clothes stand out. In today's video clip, there are several commonly used phrases.They are very funny and can make ordinary expressions come alive in an instant. Let's take a look.
This video is from the Chinese listening and speaking course for intermediate level learners in our school. If you have passed HSK2 and above, you will enjoy this course. In the class, we do three steps. First, watch a clip from a TV show or a movie.The segment has English translation and subtitles in Chinese characters and pinyin. Second, the explanation is not only about words and expressions that you might not find in your Mandarin textbooks, but also the Chinese thinking and cultural influence in expressions. These help improve your practical communication skills. Third step, we will watch the clip again, this time with only Chinese subtitles and characters.You can test your listening comprehension. In addition, there are some questions and exercises to help you become more proficient in using the new expressions. Let's start the first step. Are you ready?
Mushu and Cricket are the two intimate companions who have always accompanied Mulan. Mushu lives in the ancestral temple of the Hua family.Although its daily job is just to strike a gong to awaken the spirits of ancestors of Hua family, it seems to always cause trouble and no one believes it can do things well. The cricket is a mascot given to Mulan by her grandmother, hoping that it will help her find a good husband to marry. They were both too small to have anything to do with Mulan's ambition to join the army for her father.The ancestors of the Hua family feel that only the stone dragon in the ancestral temple can help Mulan. So they ask Mushu to wake up the stone dragon. As a result, Mushu predictably got into the trouble again.
Hey, 石头，醒醒，快去追木兰！起来，伙计，去追他，快去，去啊！嗨，醒醒，醒！ 哎呦，他们被宰了，我不可能。
巨石神龙，你醒了没有？
醒了，我刚醒，我是巨石神龙。哎，早晨好，我这就去把木兰追回来。我说我是巨石神龙，您听到了吧？
去吧，花甲未来的命运全都交给你了。
您就瞧好吧，我不会给家里丢人的。啊，压死我了，压死我了，麻烦了，这可怎么办呢？倒霉，都是那个丫头闲得难受，女扮男装惹祸生事。啊，什么？去找他？你别煽乎了，石头龙被我弄成这样，除非木兰载誉而归，否则我也回不了祠堂。啊，对，这么着，我把木兰变成英雄，那时候他们就会请我回去，真是太妙了。哦，你真了不起。哎，你跟着掺和什么？你聪明，那你说我智商不够？你敢说我傻？我拔了你的胡子，把你扔得远远的，看看谁傻，是你还是我？醒醒，快去追木兰。起来，伙计，去追他，快去。去啊。哎，醒醒醒。石头，石头！哎呦，他们被宰了，我不可能！
巨石神龙，你醒了没有？
醒了，我刚醒，我是巨石神龙。哎，早晨好，我这就去把木兰追回来。我说我是巨石神龙，您听到了吧？
去吧，花甲未来的命运全都交给你了。
您就瞧好吧，我不会给家里丢人的。啊，哎呦，他们被宰了，我不可。
他们被宰了，我不可。
哎呦，他们被宰了，我不可。
Translate, they will definitely kill me with any translation software, and you will see the same Chinese sentence. 他们一定会杀了我。一定 means to be certain that something will happen.Or to be determined to do something. For example, 我一定要去上海。他一定要买那辆车。今天这个报告一定要写完。These expressions are more formal. A casual expression that is common in everyday Chinese expression is 非不可。It means exactly the same thing as 一定。他们一定会宰了我。他们非宰了我不可。Comparing the structure of these two expressions, we will see that if we use 一定, the sentence order in Chinese and English is the same. But if you use 非不可, the sentence order is different in Chinese and English. Things that are sure to happen or insist on doing are in the middle.我一定要去上海，我非去上海不可。他一定要买那辆车，他非要买那辆车不可。今天这个报告一定要写完，今天这个报告非写完不可。Use 非不可 is not only a more authentic expression, it's also a stronger expression of being very certainthat something will happen. Let's look at a few more sentences. 如果你用这个方法，非失败不可。明天我非通过这个考试不可。明年我们的产品非进入中国市场不可。
巨石神龙， 你醒了没有？巨石神龙，你醒了没有？
巨石神龙，你醒了没有？This is a common question in daily spoken Chinese. 没有 replaces the question word 吗? And the meaning of the two sentences are exactly the same. 巨石神龙，你醒了没有？巨石神龙，你醒了吗？ But this substitution is only suitable for asking about actions that have already occurred. And not all 吗 can be replaced. For example,你吃了午饭吗？你吃了午饭没有？你看过这本书吗？你看过这本书没有？他们去过上海吗？他们去过上海没有？ All these three sentences can be substituted. The following three sentences cannot be replaced.Because they are not about actions that have already occurred.
你的男朋友会说中文吗？
你们认识 Leslie 吗？
上海离北京远吗？
Chinese people only use this substitution in casual speech, not in written or formal situations. You just need to understand it.
我是巨石神龙，早晨好。我是巨石神龙，早晨好。
我是巨石神龙，早晨好。Even people who have not studied Chinese know 你好。This is the most common and casual greeting in Chinese. It can be used at any time to anyone. But like English greetings,Chinese greetings, which emphasize formality or respect, need to be adjusted according to the time and the different forms of address. For example, at the front desk of a hotel, at a business meeting, or at the beginning of a formal speech, we may hear such English expressions. Good morning, Mr. Li. Good afternoon, General Manager Wang. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.If you want to translate these greetings into Chinese correctly, you must first understand the Chinese division of time. In the elementary Chinese textbook I wrote, there is such a table. The Chinese definitions for each time of day are listed. The most special thing is that the Chinese divided the morning into 早上 and 上午. The greeting before and after 9 is different.For Chinese people, noon starts at 11 o'clock. That is, at 11 o'clock, Chinese people can have lunch. And dinner can be served at 6. These time divisions affect not only greetings, but also operations in the service industry. According to this form, let's translate the above English greetings. Good morning, Mr. Li. The greeting before 9 o'clock should be,早上好，李先生 or 早晨好，李先生。The greeting between 9 and 11 should be 上午好，李先生。Good afternoon, General Manager Wang. Only has one Chinese expression.
下午好，王总经理。
At the beginning of a formal party, the host will say
晚上好女士们和先生们。
Another difference between Chinese and English greetings is about the noontime. In business meetings and some service industries, you will hear the polite expression 中午好 at noon. For example, if your flight has announcement in Chinese, at different times you will hear
早上好女士们和先生们。
上午好，女士们和先生们。
中午好，女士们和先生们。
下午好，女士们和先生们。
晚上好，女士们和先生们。
压死我了！压死我了！ 烦了，这可怎么办呢？倒霉，都是那个丫头，闲得难受，女扮男装，惹祸生事。嗯，啊，什么？去找她？你别煽乎了，狮驼龙被我弄成这样，除非木兰载誉而归，否则我也回不了祠堂。
压死我了！压死我了！
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 木树 was pinned down by large rocks. The stone was so heavy that 木树 cried out, 压死我了。When you see 死, do you think 木树 means it's dying? In fact, when 死 is used together with other words, it does not mean die.It's an exaggerated expression that Chinese people love to use to describe an extreme feeling. For example, 压死我了。压 and 死 together. 木叔 is exaggerating in describing the feeling that the stone is very, very heavy. This description is much more concrete and vivid than saying 石头太重了。Let's take a look at some exaggerated expressions that describe extreme feelings. 今天我忙死了，没时间吃午饭。他饿死了，一下子吃了五只汉堡。他吃了三只披萨和三只热狗，饱死了。渴死了，快给我一瓶水。下午我开了三个会，累死了。你听到打雷吗？吓死我了。热死了，我们去游泳吧。今天只有五度，冷死了。他终于通过了考试，高兴死了。
The above sentences are all in the structure of adjective plus 死, representing the most extreme feeling. Even surpassing the most advanced degree words, 非常 and 太. This expression is simple and vivid.And Chinese people love to use it in daily spoken. You can practice more.
麻烦了，这可怎么办呢？麻烦了，这可怎么办呢？
麻烦了，这可怎么办呢？麻烦了 is a useful phrase. To describe being in trouble or in crisis, you can say 麻烦了 or 有麻烦了。For example, 这个公司麻烦了。这个公司有麻烦了。老板已经知道了，你麻烦了。老板已经知道了，你有麻烦了。这个国家的经济可能麻烦了。这个国家的经济可能有麻烦了。麻烦 in Chinese can also be used as an adjective, troublesome. 这件事情太麻烦了，怎么办？那个关于中国电动汽车市场的问题有点麻烦，让我想一下。If you disturb someone, you can say, 不好意思，麻烦你了。
These Chinese examples are also three common uses of the word trouble in English. As I said before, many expressions in Chinese and English are very similar. English knowledge can sometimes help you understand Chinese faster.
倒霉，都是那个丫头。倒霉，都是那个丫头。
倒霉，都是那个丫头。
Chinese people often use 倒霉 when they complain about bad luck.
For example, 倒霉，我忘了带书。今天太倒霉了，下大雨了，我没带伞。只有他没通过考试，太倒霉了。
The opposite of 倒霉 is 幸运。他很幸运，有一些朋友帮助他。很幸运，你的病不严重。很幸运，我们最后找到了我的手机。If you want to wish someone good luck, you can say, 祝你好运。
石头龙被我弄成这样，石头龙被我弄成这样。
石头龙被我弄成这样。被 is the simple word of Chinese passive sentence. Let's start by comparing the regular sentence order with the passive sentence order using a very simple sentence. 车撞了他。他被车撞了。The normal sentence order describes the occurrence of an event. What the subject does to the object.The order of the passive sentence changes the position of the subject and object in the regular sentence in order to emphasize what the object has experienced.
石头龙被我弄成这样。
The serious consequence of the stone dragon being completely destroyed by Mu Shu are emphasized, rather than simply describing what Mu Shu did to the stone dragon.Look at these two passive sentences. Before Bei is the receiver of the action, and after the Bei is the giver of the action. Bei brings together the two parties involved in an experience. Chinese passive sentence structure explains the whole first, and then talk about what happens between the two parties. This is the Chinese thinking contained in Chinese passive sentences.This reflects a principle of Chinese social culture, which pays more attention to the connection between individuals. Let's look at the order of English passive sentences.
他被车撞了。
He was hit by the car. English passive sentences are also used to describe an experience, but the English description focuses on what happened, not the relationship between the two parties.As we can see from the sentence order, the two parties involved are separated by the verb, respectively at the beginning and the end of the sentence. Only the complete passive sentence structure can reveal the logical difference between Chinese and English. If there is no giving side of the action, the sentence order of the Chinese passive sentence and the English passive sentence is the same.
他被撞了。
He was hit.
那个男孩被打了。
That boy was beaten.
电脑被拿走了。
The computer has been taken away. When you understand the logical differences between Chinese and English passive sentences, it will be much easier for you to translate sentences correctly.
我的小宝贝被蚊子咬了。他被公司派到中国工作。冰箱里的蛋糕被谁吃完了？
我们的公司被卖了。
为什么他被送去医院？
你的名字被提到了两次。
啊，对，这么着，我把木兰变成英雄，那时候他们就会请我回去，真是太妙了！哦，你真了不起！哎，你跟着掺和什么？你聪明，那你说我智商不够？你敢说我傻？我拔了你的胡子，把你扔得远远的，看看谁傻，是你还是我？真是太妙了！哦，你真了不起！
真是太妙了，你真了不起！
真是太妙了！哦，你真了不起！
真 plus adjective is a common exclamation sentence in Chinese, which means really. Adjectives can be positive or negative. For example,
中国菜真好吃。
在中国用手机付钱真方便。昨天你给我的书真有意思。那只包真难看。这个老师的课真无聊。这个月的油真贵。太妙了 and 了不起 are both common words of praise in Chinese. Their English meanings seem similar and can be used in a variety of situations. But in fact, these two words are not as widely used in Chinese as in English.
太妙了
Chinese people generally only use to praise the text. Ideas, methods, or solutions are excellent. For example,木叔 felt that his idea was so good that he praised himself.
真是太妙了。
Let's look at some examples.
那个设计太妙了。大家都被吸引了。
这个建议太妙了。我们马上开始做。那个律师的辩护太妙了。你的办法太妙了，解决了一个大问题。了不起 is used only to praise distinguished ability or performance.
长城是一个了不起的工程。
他十岁就上大学了，真了不起。他是一个了不起的科学家。
你聪明，你聪明，
你聪明。木树 began to argue with the cricket about who was smart and who was stupid. This topic does not usually appear in Chinese textbooks, so through this clip, you will learn some common expressions that Chinese people use to discuss this topic. 聪明 means smart.Clever, intelligent. When Chinese praise cleverness, they will directly say,
你真聪明。
There are three opposite words of 聪明。傻、笨 and 蠢。However, there is a very important principle in Chinese social communication. Chinese comments generally do not use negative words directly, but use 不 plus positive words,to express negative meaning. For example, the Chinese say,
这件衣服不太漂亮。
What it probably really means is,
这件衣服很难看。
The Chinese said,
这个菜不好吃。
It means, it tastes bad. When commenting on someone's height, Chinese people will say,
你不太高
instead of saying,
你很矮。
This habit of expression reflects the cultural characteristics of respect for others and consideration of other feelings. So, if Chinese people comment on 木叔, you will hear the expression,
木叔不很聪明
or 木叔不太聪明 instead of saying,
木叔很傻
or,
木叔很笨。
If you do hear Chinese people start directly using negative words to comment or criticize, it means that Chinese people are very angry or very dissatisfied with the situation, and they don't care about the other person's feelings, but directly express their views clearly. For example,
他太笨了，一直犯一样的错误。这种做法很傻。你的想法很蠢。
In my advanced Chinese course, I have been reminding my students of this Chinese communication habit. Because from the change of expression, Chinese people's real thoughts can be judged or predicted.
那你说我智商不高？ 那你说我智商不够？
那你说我的智商不够？智商 means intelligence quotient, IQ. It's a scientific term. 聪明 is just a common word to praise. If you want to praise smart in a special way, you can say, 智商很高。Because IQ is measured in numbers, the terms 高 and 低 are used to describe it. The cricket thought 木叔 was 智商不够to mean not smart enough. IQ is related to the brain, so the Chinese will also use 脑子 to describe the smart. You will hear Chinese people say, 你的脑子真好to praise cleverness. The Chinese say, 没脑子 means stupid, foolish. But it sounds much better than just saying 很笨or 很傻. Okay, I have summarized several ways Chinese people say smart or stupid. Praise can be very direct, but if you want to criticize, I want to stress again the Chinese principle of social communication.For the purpose of respecting others, try to avoid using negative terms such as 傻, 笨, and 蠢. If you soften your negative comments and give face to others, people will return the favor.
你敢说我傻？我拔了你的胡子！你敢说我傻？我拔了你的胡子！
你敢说我傻？我拔了你的胡子！When Mushu says that, it sounds like a threat. Its tone is decided by a keyword, 敢, there too. In both Chinese and English, the addition of this word makes an ordinary expression very strong. We can feel it clearly by this comparison.
你说我傻，我拔了你的胡子。
你敢说我傻，我拔了你的胡子。All Chinese expressions related to 敢 represent a kind of courage. Recently, when I was discussing the case of electric cars in China with advanced Chinese class students, some students said,
中国的电动汽车越来越好，因为很多中国工程师很年轻，他们敢想敢做。
敢 can also be used to ease your challenge. For example,
你敢和我竞争吗？你怎么敢？你敢说实话吗？
When I was learning English, my English teacher said, Don't be shy, you should dare to speak.Oral English will become more and more fluent. Now I'm giving you the same advice.
不要害羞，要敢开口，中文口语才会越来越流利。
The exercise sections in each of our videos are a great opportunity to practice speaking. With more practice, you will become more and more confident in expressing yourself in Chinese.
Alright, let's go through the clip again. Then we will do two exercises. Answer questions and a sentence translation.
嘿，石头，醒醒，快去追木兰！起来，伙计，去追他，快去！去啊！石头，石头，哎呦，他们非宰了我不可！
巨石神龙，你醒了没有？
啊，醒了，我刚醒，我是巨石神龙，哎，早晨好，我这就去把木兰追回来。我说我是巨石神龙，您听到了吧？
去吧， 花家未来的命运全都交给你了。
您就瞧好吧，我不会给家里丢人的。啊，
压死我了，压死我了。
麻烦了，这可怎么办呢？倒霉，都是那个丫头闲得难受，女扮男装惹祸生事。嗯，啊，什么？去找他？你别煽乎了，狮驼龙被我弄成这样，除非木兰载誉而归，否则我也回不了祠堂。啊，对，这么着，我把木兰变成英雄，那时候他们就会请我回去，真是太妙了。哦，你真了不起。哎，你跟着掺和什么？你聪明，那你说我智商不高？你敢说我傻？我拔了你的胡子，把你扔得远远的，看看谁傻，是你还是我？
Exercise 1. Answer questions. Please answer 5 questions based on the movie. Each question is read twice. Answer yourself first, and then you will see the answer.
一，为什么木叔要叫醒巨石神龙？为什么木叔要叫醒巨石神龙？为什么木叔要叫醒巨石神龙？因为祖先让巨石神龙去追木兰。二，木叔为什么觉得有麻烦了？木叔为什么觉得有麻烦了？木叔为什么觉得有麻烦了？因为巨石神龙被木叔破坏了。三，蟋蟀建议木叔做什么？蟋蟀建议木叔做什么？蟋蟀建议木叔做什么？蟋蟀建议木叔去找木兰。四，蟋蟀觉得木叔聪明还是不太聪明？蟋蟀觉得木叔聪明还是不太聪明？蟋蟀觉得木叔聪明还是不太聪明？蟋蟀觉得木叔不太聪明。五，蟋蟀说木叔傻，木叔要做什么？蟋蟀说木叔傻，木叔要做什么？蟋蟀说木叔傻，木叔要做什么？木叔要拔了蟋蟀的胡子。
Exercise 2. Sentence translation. You must translate each sentence into Chinese, using the words or phrases explained earlier. And then you can check the answer. Please pay attention to the order of the sentences. The order of the sentences determines whether you are expressing your ideas accurately.
五点前我非回家不可。五点前我非回家不可。他非让我告诉他不可。怎么办？他非让我告诉他不可。怎么办？下雨了，他非骑车去学校不可。为什么？下雨了，他非骑车去学校不可。为什么？早上好，你去上班吗？早上好，你去上班吗？早晨好，你去上班吗？早晨好，你去上班吗？大家上午好，我们要讨论下星期的工作。大家上午好，我们要讨论下星期的工作。中午好，我们有牛肉套餐和鸡肉套餐，你要吃什么？中午好，我们有牛肉套餐和鸡肉套餐，你要吃什么？下午好，你们要试试新的水果茶吗？下午好，你们要试试新的水果茶吗？晚上好，女士们和先生们，欢迎大家参加我们的晚会。晚上好，女士们和先生们，欢迎大家参加我们的晚会。这个房间热死了，快开空调。这个房间热死了，快开空调。我已经24小时没睡觉了，困死了。我已经24小时没睡觉了，困死了。这个菜里有很多辣椒，辣死了。这个菜里有很多辣椒，辣死了。 这个问题麻烦死了，大家都不知道怎么解决。这个问题麻烦死了，大家都不知道怎么解决。如果你不想有麻烦，就少说多做。如果你不想有麻烦，就少说多做。你看了新闻吗？那个公司在美国有麻烦了。你看了新闻吗？那个公司在美国有麻烦了。倒霉，我又忘了我的眼镜。倒霉，我又忘了我的眼镜。倒霉，这个周末从上海到北京的飞机票都卖完了。倒霉，这个周末从上海到北京的飞机票都卖完了。太晚了，没有地铁了，真倒霉。太晚了，没有地铁了，真倒霉。太幸运了，我买到了最后一张票。太幸运了，我买到了最后一张票。能通过这个考试的人都很幸运。能通过这个考试的人都很幸运。你们准备好了吗？祝你们好运。你们准备好了吗？祝你们好运。桌子上的薯片和巧克力被我的同事拿走了。桌子上的薯片和巧克力被我的同事拿走了。他上个星期买的自行车被偷了。他上个星期买的自行车被偷了。 那个足球队被禁止参加这个比赛。那个足球队被禁止参加这个比赛。真倒霉，老板看到我迟到了。真倒霉，老板看到我迟到了。我真幸运能和你一起工作。我真幸运能和你一起工作。真麻烦，我找不到我的行李了。真麻烦，我找不到我的行李了。这本书写得太妙了。这本书写得太妙了。我们住在海边的酒店吗？太妙了。我们住在海边的酒店吗？太妙了。他说在中国旅行太妙了，因为每个地方不一样。他说在中国旅行太妙了，因为每个地方不一样。第一个苹果手机真了不起。第一个苹果手机真了不起。这个小公司做了最好的无人机。真了不起。这个小公司做了最好的无人机。真了不起。每个跑完45公里的人都很了不起。每个跑完45公里的人都很了不起。那个回答很聪明。那个回答很聪明。 猪看上去有点笨，但是很聪明。猪看上去有点笨，但是很聪明。我真傻，怎么会相信你？我真傻，怎么会相信你？海豚的智商很高。和六岁的孩子差不多。海豚的智商很高，和六岁的孩子差不多。你有没有脑子？为什么同意？你有没有脑子？为什么同意？用你的脑子想一想，别马上回答。用你的脑子想一想，别马上回答。你敢一个人去爬山吗？你敢一个人去爬山吗？开会的时候，没有人敢说话。开会的时候，没有人敢说话。他不敢告诉父母，他辞职了。他不敢告诉父母，他辞职了。
Today is the final clip from our selection of the Mulan movie. Although it is only 4 short clips, we see the core ideas of Mulan's story. 爱、友情、勇敢、独立。Next time, we are going to start a new Disney movie. Which one could it be? You will know then. See you next time.